YouTube. This is Bailey, and I'm
What's
Haley, and then that's Carter.
up?
That's Hannah in the corner.
Yep.
This is my 10-gallon Crab-a-Tot. Bailey's the Bailey. Her hermit crab is gonna be staying in here, along with my three other hermit crabs for a little while until she gets hers set up. What I have on my 10-gallon is I thought it was ridiculous to buy a top for it, so what I did was I grabbed a bathroom towel and just laid it on top of it to lock in moisture. Just put that right there. And then, this is just a Payless bag. I just put a grocery bag and taped it along the side of the tank on all sides except for this back side, so I could flip it over when I wanted to get into my Crab-a-Tot. This is the inside of the Crab-a-Tot. Got a coconut hut here. We got some food and that, and there's their sorry, no, I'm moving. There's their little swimming pool. Put a shell on it so they can crawl out and all kinds of stuff. Yeah, there's their shells, extra shells. This is my hermit crab right here, but. All right, so let's meet the newest hermit crab. This is Bailey's hermit crab, Chum Chum. Bailey, I need your assistance. This is Chum Chum. Chum Chum is very adorable. He has a broken shell, and he's actually like five sizes too small for his shell. I'll show you what it looks like when Bailey comes over here, what it looks like when he's all the way in his shell. This is what it looks like when he's all the way in his shell. His eyes are still out, and he's actually completely all the way in his shell.
He was.
He was, but yeah. This is Chum Chum, and we rescued him because they say that he won't change shells, but I think that's a whole bunch of bull honky because I think that they just treat them wrong and they don't have enough substrate. Like, I have a lot of substrate. That's about a good 5 inches of substrate right there. So they can bury themselves and shed. Oh, one of my babies is eating their nuts. I'll talk about their food that they have. Well, Bailey can play with hers on the floor. But yeah, that's him.
They like to explore.
They love to explore. We already gave them baths today so they'd be ready for showtime. But in here, which my hermit crab, Aries, she's in there. The lighting's better right there. She's eating some chai seed and sunflower seeds and all kinds of stuff. You want to hold her? I'll show you. But yeah, she's pretty cool. This is Aries. She's the second hermit crab I got. Sorry, baby, I'll put you back in there. She's the second hermit crab I got. She's pretty small. She's smaller than Bailey's, but he has a smaller shell. But yeah, she's pretty cool. And then the other thing I feed them is in this dish, I have shrimpies, coconut. And, or I mean, not coconut, some banana, dried banana, and some lettuce. They love, love, love lettuce. Mine do at least. We'll show you other hermit crabs too. This is the last one I've gotten. He's my jumbo hermit crab. He's huge. His name's Zeus. Because he's the granddaddy of all. You want to hold him? He's the granddaddy of all hermit crabs. He's pretty big compared to Bailey's hands. And then, yeah, they're all going to come out to play. That's Zeus. And then I have a miracle story with this little guy. So, I don't know if you guys have ever heard of Stress Coat, but he's not coming out right now. He might come out in a second. Bailey will get him come out. But this little guy, got him about 6 months ago, and he has literally never came out of his shell in front of anybody. I knew he was alive because, you know, he's in a shell, and usually when they die in their shell, but they're not as compact.
See, he's coming out.
He's kind of coming out a little bit. We just gently shake him a little bit back and forth. And
back. Wait 2 seconds. One, two.
See? And you just back and forth.
Keep going. And usually, sometimes they like it, but sometimes they don't. So then they'll come out of their shell and, like, try to crawl away, and then you'll be able to see.
Mm-hmm.
To tell if it's a girl or a boy, girls have spots on their sides, and boys have stripes on their sides. So this one is
a female. You can't really see yet, but
she's almost out. Hold on.
Yeah. The story of her is that here. We can just let her see if she'll crawl around on the floor when we put her down.
Oh, God, I don't. Oh, there's. Oh, God, there's a centipede.
But anyway, the story of her is that she never came out in front of anybody ever before in her life. Until I got this miracle. This miracle came to me one day. And I'm going to leave that there real fast. Like, grab something. The miracle. This is all my hermit crab stuff. The miracle that saved her life. It's called Stress Coat. It's actually for aquarium fish. I don't know if you could see that. It's actually for aquarium fish. Fish for aquarium. It has aloe vera in it. It's very good. For hermit crabs, though. And I saw this on a video by, I'm going to do a shout out. I'm forgetting her. Oh, what is her name? Bailey's going to look up her name. But she's a really, really smart lady. She knows all about hermit crabs, and I saw that she bathes her hermit crabs in Stress Coat. It's for aquarium fish, but she says it helps really, really well with hermit crabs. And my hermit crab, actually, after never ever walking on my hand ever, or coming out in front of me, he walks on my hand now. After I take him a bath in Stress Coat, he actually comes alive and, you know, takes a bath with me and all kinds of stuff. It's really nice, and he walks on my hands, and he comes out when I talk now, and he's near me, and ever since I washed him in the Stress Coat, honestly, the day I washed him in it, he came out. Her name is, yeah, let's see, Yadokari Nation. I don't see if you can see that on YouTube. Yadokari Nation. One word. But she's very, very, very smart lady. That's my dog. She's barking on the other side of the door. But she's a very, very smart lady, and I love her videos, and she's very wise. But Stress Coat, I highly recommend getting it when you get your hermit crab. It might save your hermit crab's life. This is my dechlorinated water. Oh, and Stress Coat is also a water dechlorinator. It takes out chlorine. I don't know if you can see it.
Paisley, stop it.
But it takes out chlorine. And so that way I gave my other one to her, my pre-dechlorinator. But I think we should take him a bath. What do you think?
Yeah.
We'll have another bath video after I'm done showing the rest of my cage. But back here I have a climbing wall that I got with a previous cage. It's just a little wire one. I just put it in there because they like it. They absolutely love their coconut hut. This isn't a real one, but they definitely love it. And these are all their little shells. Pretty little shells for them. And their water dish. Two sponges. Nets. They're beautiful. It's my favorite part of the tank. They're beautiful, beautiful, beautiful swimming pool. And a nice little decal that's up against the window. and a little palm tree in the corner. But yeah, and they like to hide behind the hermit crab hut, so I added a little neon bush back there. But yeah, they're pretty cool. I used coconut fiber substrate and all kinds of stuff. And yeah, this is my hermit crab. This is their area where I keep all of their information. This is actually for babies, but I keep their nuts in there. That's in that bowl over there. They're nuts. And this is the kind of food I used to feed them, but now that I'm feeding them real food, I don't really feed it to them anymore. Yeah, I thought that they'd like real food, so stop feeding them that. Hey, Carter, can you bring me those bananas? And the spicy coconut. Yep. So I bought these two today at the store. They're very cheap. This was only $1.50 and this was $2. But I didn't realize, I guess I must have missed the heat in the little, the little fire pepper. But yeah, these are coconut chips and they are spicy, so I cannot give them to my hermit crabs. That sucks. Don't know who likes spicy hermit crab or coconuts. But I also got them banana chips. That's what's in there right now. Just banana chips. They're natural. All natural banana chips. Oh. That's not good. I dumped the banana chips out. Sorry, guys. You can talk to Bailey for a second.
Hi, guys. So, Hannah and Carter are... That's Carter and that's Hannah. They're sitting up there just watching us make a video.
Oh, look, he's making a break for it.
They're like, run for it.
But Bailey picked up some of these from our grandma's house from McDonald's. It's kind of mixed around. Hey, but McDonald's, they are peanuts, just chopped peanuts that you get with the sundaes. Oh, my dog, she wants them here really bad. But they're just chopped peanuts that you get with the sundaes. And I read them, and there's actually nothing in them at all. There's no sodium, which is weird. I thought there'd be sodium. See, zero sodium. There's nothing in them. No, because the hermit crabs are out. Just, I don't know what to do with her. But yes. Thank you, Carter. Carter to the rescue. Go out there with my puppy. She gets sad. She has separation anxiety. But yeah, so we got peanuts for them and some bananas. And yeah, they're really well taken care of. So bye, Bailey. We'll see you guys in the next video.
Bye. We're going to give them baths.
So yep. So that's in the next video. Okay.
That's it.